All right, so let's talk and do a little demonstration on the arc filtering in MasterCam. I have another video on this that shows the toolpath size changes, so definitely watch that video. That's what most people talk about when it comes to this is the size of the toolpath, what it's actually doing in analyzed toolpath, putting in, output to entry arc, and what it's actually doing to the code itself. Well, in this demo, I just want to show you graphically what it's doing as best I can. So for this example, I want to go to wireframe and I'm going to draw a simple spline, something like that. Okay, just something simple. All right, and then what I want to do is I'm going to end up offsetting that in a minute, but I want to put a simple contour toolpath in this. So I'm going to pick a regular Haas mill. No real crazy settings here. This is just an example. So I'm going to do a contour. I'm just going to grab that spline. And actually, I take that back. What I'm going to end up doing here, I'll leave that. I want to create a spline a little more definition to make sure that this actually goes through here. So I'll go here, something along those lines. That's better. I just want to make sure that I can illustrate this as best I can. So a toolpath contour, and I'm going to select that spline, and the tool, I mean, it really doesn't matter. We'll just use a half inch end mill. Don't care about any of the speeds and feeds. Cut parameters, I want to turn the compensation off. All right, lead in, lead out is going to be off. Everything else, linking parameters, all that doesn't matter. What matters is the arc filter. We're going to leave it alone right now. This is default settings right now. So we'll go to total tolerance of 1 thou. That's fine. We'll hit green check. Okay, and then you'll see, look closely, the blue toolpath line and the green nominal geometry. And that blue line is allowed to deviate from this green line, okay, plus or minus 1 thou. Okay, so let's illustrate this a little better. Let's go into wireframe, and I'm going to go to offset. I'm going to offset by 10 thousandths both sides of this spline. Okay, both sides, all right? And then just to make sure this is accurate, I'll clear colors, and I'm gonna analyze distance from here to there, and that's 10 thousandths. So this is plus or minus 10, okay? Let's go into parameters, and let's change our cut tolerance to 10 thousandths, and hit green check. And you will see, look at the toolpath, deviate. Now, like I said before, this toolpath, there it is going this way, there it is going that way, 10 thousandths. It is not, the total tolerance being 10 thou is, the cut tolerance is not, it's not plus or minus 5, okay? You'll see it's allowed to deviate either side of nominal, okay? That's why generally I say with arc filtering, I do not allow the cut tolerance, the total tolerance, especially if you're using line arc filtering and things like that. I don't allow the cut tolerance to deviate more than half of what you're leaving. Okay? So if you're only leaving, 5 thousandths, thinking that this is plus or minus 5, total 10, obviously you're going to have issues. Okay? If we go into analyze toolpath, you'll see the cutter. The cutter is going towards the Y minus direction a little bit. And it gets over here and it's going to the Y positive direction. And see how notchy it is? Okay. So let's refine this a little bit. Let's go into parameters and let's change the cut tolerance to half of that, so 5 thou. And green check. And you'll see now we're within the lines. Okay, it deviates that way a little bit. Deviates this way a little bit. Okay. But you can see this is plus or minus 10, or plus or minus 10, so a total of 20. If we increase this to 20 thou, okay, you'll see now we have problems. It's going way out, okay? If we actually go in and go to wireframe and offset this by another 10 thousandths, you'll see that it's within, okay? So know that in the parameters that the total tolerance is not bilateral. Okay, or it's unilateral. So it's 20 thou per side it's allowed to deviate. So if we go to 10 thousandths, you'll see that we're in, okay? Because it's allowed to deviate 10 thousandths max per side. If we go to 15, okay, well, it might be in, but see, it's out over here, way out. Okay, just so you're aware. Right. So the max, this is a 20 thou tolerance. The max you could deviate is going to be 10 thousandths in your arc filtering. Okay. So that's just the cut tolerance, right? And that applies right to the nominal geometry. All right. Now, this is boxed here because the line arc filtering and smoothing, okay, have to do with the data that we have currently. So these apply to the blue line created from the cut tolerance allowable deviation. Okay, so if we get in here and just put line arc filtering on, and I usually split this 50-50, so that's how much of the cut tolerance versus line arc filtering, how it's split up. Okay, so you're reducing the cut tolerance and then also refining the line arc tolerance for a total tolerance of 10 thousandths. Okay, so if I hit green check, you will now see that it's smoother. And what happens is the line arc tolerance will try to put arcs in given a certain, you know, within 5 thousandths. You can refine that. Okay, 10 thou is a big number. But instead of having a bunch of small lines like we were output, okay, you get radii when possible. So if we put this over more to the line arc filtering, the cut tolerance decreases, line arc filtering increases, if we hit green check, you'll see that we're deviating, but we're getting big arcs. So if we get into the analyze toolpath, you'll see we have a lot of, that's a G3 move. So you're getting, allowing it to flow with G circular interpolation movements instead of linear movements, okay? So generally, line arc filtering is good for standard geometry. Arcs, it's not good. So, you know, especially with 3D milling, when you use this, or even dynamic milling, typically with dynamic is to reduce the length of the toolpath. It is a good idea to go no more than half of what you're leaving. So if you're leaving, you know, if we look at this here, if this is what you want and you're leaving 10 thousandths, that's not going to work. Okay, so if you're leaving 10 thousandths, the most you'd be able to deviate would be like 5 thousandths. So we turn our line arc filtering off and change this to 5. You'll see that it deviates. Now it is going to cut in a little bit, okay, when it can. But if it's a plus or minus, you know, 3 or 4 tolerance, you know, you got to be aware of what this is doing. It's not, it's working both sides. It's trying to interpolate the geometry, in this case linear movements, based on a total tolerance of, really the total tolerance is 5 thousandths, but plus or minus on each 5 thousandths on each side of nominal. So if we go to line arc filtering, we can reduce the cut tolerance to, let's say, 3 thousandths. Okay, then I usually split it, and that's usually a pretty standard spec here. I'll reduce that so it's 3 thou. And then we can create arcs in XY only. That's all we need for this one. And then the minimum arc radius, you can tweak that, let's say 5 thousandths. And hit green check. And you'll see this toolpath flows. There are still some straight lines in there if we get an analyzed toolpath. There's a G2 there. There's a G1. There's a G1. So it's not really cutting what you think it is. Okay, there are some G1 moves in there. Okay, so let's further, set this up. If we have, you know, if we want arcs, and I'm not saying that's more efficient, but if we want a lot of arcs, we really need to allow it to flow more. So we need to go over to the line arc area and allow the arcs to be created in the total tolerance better. So green check. And then if we go to analyze toolpath, you'll see that we have a G2. We have a G2. See the arcs forming instead of linear moves? Okay. So the line arc filtering will allow it to create lines and arcs because the cut tolerance is reducing. So that means that the initial figuring out, or the original deviation from nominal is only a tenth and 50 millionths, the lines and arcs allows to deviate more of the total tolerance. That's what the slider is kind of about. Smoothing is a little different. You can apply smoothing and line arc filtering. I'll be honest, the only time I really use smoothing for general geometry is going to be to make sure if I am leading in with a helix, I output 3D arc entry motion. My other video covers why that is. The other thing is I will minimize number of points sometimes. If I am doing an example like this, I will do that. Typically, in my experience, smoothing is used for non-geometric geometry, so freeform surfaces, things like that. So even with smoothing on, you know, we'll split the arc and the smoothing, roughly. And we'll see what we do. And you'll see now it's pretty close. There are some straight lines, okay? To get rid of that, we can crank it over, reducing the cut tolerance, increasing the line arc and the smoothing tolerance. And you'll see we get a more realistic, you know, what you would expect from this machine. So it, you know, it does quite a bit. This is just a simple spline example, but if you have a model, my understanding is that MasterCam still looks at it, you know, tessellated, a bunch of triangles. So this really comes into play there, and especially if it's non, if it's a freeform surface, smoothing is very important. General settings, line arc filtering will decrease the length of code, smoothing will increase the length of code. So typically, I won't have smoothing on. If I'm really trying to get, you know, this as accurate as possible, there are times when I'm down to half a thou for the total tolerance, and then I will split this. That is generally what I do. I allow arcs to form, but I allow the cut tolerance is going to be small anyway, then the arcs are allowed to form within that range. So if I hit green check, and you'll see we are very close, okay? It is still going to be G1 moves. Now, they're very fine, okay? If you really want the G2s, you have to shove that tolerance to line arc filtering. So that will really make the cut tolerance very fine, but allow arcs to form within the half a thousandths. It is getting pretty tight tolerance now, but you'll see the G2s forming. That is up to you. Okay, if you really want those G2, G3 moves, that's how you do it. The other thing is to take a look at the size of the toolpath. That's, in the, again, covered in the other video. But it's a 9.2 kilobyte program now. If I increase this total tolerance to 5,000ths and turn line arc filtering off and green check, a little bit shorter. Okay, if I turn line arc filtering on and split it and hit green check, shorter again. Okay. If you increase this tolerance to 10 thou, shorter again, because it's less code. Then if you go into here and shift it all over to the line arc, and so you're reducing the cut tolerance, all right, 8.1, even shorter. Because instead of having all those G1 moves, you're using larger G2 or G3 moves. Okay, so that's the addition I wanted to put in a line arc filtering. There is another, again, there's another video on my channel about this that has a part example using a 2D dynamic toolpath. And that shows you sort of in reality what you would be doing for shortening the program and things like that. In the future, I will do a 3D machining example. And we'll take a look at the points. Again, if you get into the view, that's one thing I forgot here, is turn the view on, and if you do this, you can see all the arc points. You can see where this is arcing. If you split this here, or even just turn line arc filtering off for an example, you'll see all the notches, the green points or the line end points. If you tighten this tolerance up to our default settings, you'll see all the straight lines. Okay? You'll see all the end points with green dots. Alright? Again, remember, the cut tolerance affects the toolpath calculation from nominal, and that it is unilateral. So if you put 1 thou, it's allowed to vary plus 1 or minus 1. So this is minus, this one's plus over here, from the nominal. When you put line arc filtering or smoothing on, they're in a separate box here. These affect the calculated toolpath that results from the cut tolerance calculation. Okay, they're a refinement of the cut tolerance. All right. All of these areas here add up to a total tolerance. All right. So hopefully that was helpful. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below or shoot me an email. You know, it takes a little bit getting used to. A lot of newer controls, I guess, some people don't even mess with these. I find that if I'm looking for surface finish or a very smooth program, I do use it. So high-speed machining, dynamic milling, Mastercam's dynamic tool paths, any 3D machining, anything in the 3D gallery. And also in the multi-axis gallery, depending on what you're doing. You know, morph or parallel, things like that. You know, you'll use it. You don't use it too much on contour. So it's dynamic style tool paths. It's going to be your 3D and multi-axis, where you do have to mess with that for surface finish purposes, length of code purposes, or just how the program, to make sure it's not notchy. So again, if you have any questions or comments, leave them below. And thanks for watching.